Hello and welcome to my channel. I hope you managed to have a good time during these Yule days with your friends and family, despite this corona lockdown thing. I had a good time. I went to the mainland and visited my family's farmhouse and celebrated the Yuletide with my closest family for a couple of days. And they decided to gift me this Geiger Counter kit. I always wanted the Geiger Counter. I don't know anything about physics or just think it's fun. So, I know it's not a retro thing, but I wanted to make a video where I play around with it anyway. So that is currently what you are watching. But first, intro time! First, I will unbox the thing, take out all the components and check that the kit is complete. The manual is very specific about this. And while we're at it, the manual in general is very good and very detailed. And the only thing it assumes is that you know how to solder. Everything else is outlined in such detail that anybody should be able to build this kit. As a rule of thumb, when you build a PCB, you should start with the lowest and less heat sensitive component and work your way up from there. This is probably why the manual tells me to start by soldering on all the resistors, followed by the diodes. I might do this a bit different than most, but I have found it way easier to solder from the top of the board whenever it's possible, which is why you see me solder from the top on almost all of the simple components. Other components, such as the side switch or the variable resistor, are held down with a piece of painter's tape, while others, like the sockets for integrated circuits, can hold themselves down by friction alone. Either way, I always start by tacking down one leg with a blob of solder to hold it to the board. Then I won't need to worry about if the component sticks to the board or not, and I can instead use my free hand to make sure the component is mounted flat up against the board while reheating the only soldered leg, and when I'm satisfied about that, I solder all the remaining legs. But be aware, if you keep the first leg heated for too long, you risk burning your fingers or destroying the component, so maybe start by practicing this on some cheap components and a PCB that you don't care about. If you buy this kit, you get to choose between a variant with or without a laser cutted cabinet. If you get the version with the cabinet, you have to remember to use the dip switch from the component packets because it needs to be a bit longer. Then we need to solder on the battery holder. That also needs a small bolt and a nut in order to be kept in place. After that, I insert the integrated circuits into the sockets and finally the Geiger tube, which is very fragile and should be treated with the utmost care. And now before I turn it on, I need to assemble the cabinet, mainly because the circuit itself generates very high voltage. It is not really dangerous as such, but it could shock you, and that is unpleasantly enough in itself. The cabinet consists of two pieces of laser cut acrylic, which are held together by some spacers and a handful of screws. These cabinets are very popular for DIY kits. I don't really like them, but I don't like being shocked either. Now, let's see. I get some weak beeps. This should be what is known as background radiation, or so I've been told. I borrowed some uranium from a friend of mine. Let's see what happens if I put it near the detector. This is so awesome. According to the manual, this device is hackable. It would be cool to see the code for the microcontroller. It would also be cool to get hold of some more samples to test with it. And maybe a professional Geiger counter to compare with. But this is it for now. This was a fun little project, which I'm probably going to improve upon on a later point in time. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. And then I guess I see you out there in the dark corners of the interwebs.